Welcome back in another video of my channel. Today we are going to make a new video for Marvel Future Fight, and we are going to talk about the new uniform of X-23. We are going to test her in some contents, and all of that we are going to do it now. So I don't have her awakening state. I didn't bought her uniform yet. I will do it all with you. So I will start with the awakening state. Those are the requirements if you don't know already. I didn't have money, so I had to do some stages and some stuff until I'll be sure. So yeah, it is a little hard because with those kind of updates we have so far, it is hard for us to keep up with the characters that they introduce into the games and the uniforms instead. So I'm going to buy her uniform. The price was 1550, the original price, and 1050, the discounted price. We are going to see the how many uniforms XP it needs. So here it needs 100 level 1 to maximize 100%, and the first one, it is the Blade of Avengers, okay, and those are the requirements. I have everything I need so far. I don't know about the gold yet. I have only 3 million. The next one, it is we need 67 level 2 uniform chips. Excellent. The next is Yelena Belova. I'm not going to use any upgrade ticket because I have a ton of biometrics of her. Excellent, we are keeping up. The next needs 758 level 3 uniform chips. And those kind of materials and stuff. The next option is Star-Lord Grounded. Excellent. The next one, basically I will start using all of my those are the uniforms we need. Maybe if you have more than level 1 and 2 you will understand what it is and what it she wants. The next one is Mysterio Spider-Man Far From Home. Excellent. And the last one, she needs Emma Frost Phoenix 5. That is also quite of in use. I really am happy that I got here. So I will leave the HP. I really just want to see if I have anything. Oh yeah, the best one is HP and attack for this one. Okay, let me check her stats. We have already maximized the attack speed, the ignore defense, yeah, it is from my cards. I have an extra for this one. We lack on critical damage, critical rate, some cooldown, but we are going to test her as she is. But let me first upgrade her overall this. So we need all of those materials. I lacked because I upgraded two of mutants lately, so I'm not able to use her at full awakening skill, so we lack on those buffs we have so far from her last skill. Okay, let me see if I have any on the inbox. Let me get also those boxes. So this is why I'm trying these days not to make any guide or something, because I lack the materials. It is so hard for me, so I really have to go to the lab and produce some of them. I need the one for another. So I'm going to use her as she is right now. I will make another video further for null and stuff, because right now, even if I have done here 70 level, I'm not able to upgrade the gears because I lack of TCP, as always. So we are going to test here as is. As you see over here, she has agility and healing. I thought she had the weapon master, but anyway, she doesn't. Let's see her skills. The passive, we have already the critical damage we lack, so the critical damage is already capped with this one. The increased guaranteed critical rate is also 35%, but it is quite the maximum also again. We have an increasement skill of skill damage by 20% and increased bonus damage by 15%. The first skill we have bleed damage, the second one it is another bleed damage with physical effect. Here we have our accumulation, where it is based on the defense and the dodge rate. So the next one, it is the fourth skill that give us also some paralyze here. It may be a good option for the ABX of paralyze season. So as for the last, we have the passive that sees recovering HP and has active buffs if she's 99% less HP. That is also quite nice. And the fifth skill that decreasing all defense down, and that is also quite nice. So we are going to preview a little bit the skills inside so we understand how the rotation will work. So the attack are the same, nothing too much changed. The 1, 2, 4 are the skills that we use to prevent the enemies to hit us. It is the those are the skills that we spent until the rest of the skills cooldown come up. So the actual skills that we're going to use will be 3, cancel 6, cancel 5. This will be our actual rotation. As you see over here, the chain hit damage is amazing. I suggest you energy, CDP of energy, or CDP of rage for her. Those two are the best options for her. The rest, I have right now the obelisk 200% max HP and recovery. She was based on the HP and recovery from before, because I had her only for Shadowland. Yet I still lack some of the some of the CTPs and stuff yet, so yeah, I'm not going to spend some good CTPs on her yet, because even if she is good, yep, I'm not going to use her, at least when I'm ready to use awakening characters. So I'm going to use the team we use to one shot for the beginning, and after that we are going to use her at ABX to see what kind of things she could do. Okay, I hope I won't one shot, because I don't want to spend my days for this one, and I really have to climb more to see what is her potential. Right now the skill, remember that it is level 1, so we are going 3, 6 and 5. Oh my god, 72 stage with level 1 awakening skill without even transcended, level 20 gears, and look at the damage with a simple obelisk. Okay, I think this is amazing. Let me try the second team that I have. Oh yeah, I was increasing my potential for some characters. The strikers are the same, we just need the Doctor Strange to freeze the world boss in the same position to do the most of the damage we could. But let's go. So yeah, we are going out. Go up 6 and 5. Yeah, it doesn't work with this team as I thought. The next of the rotation will be 3 and 5. This is the rotation we have. Maybe the co-op was a little bit faster than I thought, but yeah, the best team is the team that I thought. I'm going to use here with the team of Nick Fury and Coulson to see how exactly is the damage of here without the team of co-op. Okay, we are going to use the buff also. Okay, I think for an obelisk and a level 72 stage and a half builded character is quite amazing, right? You know, I will definitely build here because I lack of character with physical attack, and she will be in a very good, you know, addition for the ABX of female comp. Oh my god, look at the damage. Weapon Hex just came out and applied the all defense down. Oh my god, look at the damage. Guys, I really think that with an energy and with a proper build and cards and stuff, I don't even have Odin's. Okay, I don't think the survivability is amazing. Look at the... yeah. The timing wasn't, but anyway. So that was the video, guys, for today. I hope you enjoyed. If you ask me, I think the uniform was amazing. It is, of course, a big upgrade for the X23. I will have a clearer view of her when she will be transcended, but even from now, I think she's amazing. She definitely worth it to be awakening already. I have here on my personal awakening list, as you see over here, yeah, a little bit high, because I knew that already she will be high, so I have big hopes for her. When I will be ready to get energy for her and all rage or something, I will definitely go for null to test her more, but I have already my team, so I'm more of ABX for her. I really want to make her a beast, because with the support of Valkyria, she's going to be a beast. So that was the video. I hope you enjoyed. Until the next video, see you soon. Bye.